Mr. Deputy Chairman, sir, I want to thank all the honourable members who have taken the floor and participated in this discussion, and I think all of them have supported the substance of the bill, which is that this should be passed before 31st December, because the punitive, not to do so, would invite punitive action and result in the relief which has been available since 2017 to suddenly not be available, and that would lead to large-scale demolitions, etc. The bill in 2017, which passed into an act, covered seven categories, Mr. Deputy Chairman, sir. Slum dwellers, jhuggi jhopri clusters, urban street vendors, unauthorized colonies, village abadi areas and their extensions, existing farmhouses involving construction beyond permissible building limits, schools, dispensaries, religious and cultural institutions, special areas, walled city extension and Karol Bagh, all other areas within the National Capital Territory of Delhi. Each of these had a separate cut-off point and cut-off date. Now, a lot of suggestions have been made, Mr. Deputy Chairman, sir, as to why has nothing been done since 2008. And I would like to respond briefly to the Honourable Parvez Hashmi ji. Say that between 2008 and 2014, why nothing was done, I don't have the answer. The fact of the matter is that no colony has been regularized after 2008. I do have an answer, or I think I have an explanation of what happened post-2014. An attempt has been made to fast-track this procedure. The Supreme Court had appointed a committee under the chairmanship of the Secretary in the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. That committee has met several times, but as many honourable members have said, this is a multi-stakeholder exercise where the central government has to cooperate along with the DDA, the Delhi government and other agencies in order to be able to delineate the precise areas where unauthorized colonies have come up. The nature of the unauthorized construction in the seven categories that I have mentioned. I should mention one of the categories of street vendors, we have been able to enact separate legislation so that we are not seeking protection for street vendors under this legislation now. But what has happened is that the government of the National Capital Territory of Delhi, the Delhi government, has given an affidavit, Mr. Deputy Chairman, sir, before the High Court to say that it requires two more years to complete the exercise which it had embarked upon. Now, if the Delhi government cannot complete the work for 2 years, we are left with no option but to seek this three-year extension. Let me explain. When the then, my distinguished predecessor, the then Minister of Housing and Urban Development, piloted this through the Lok Sabha in December 2017, he expressed the hope that this would possibly be the last occasion in which he would be, with the government would be coming to seek this extension. But in May 2017, after several meetings of this committee had taken place, the Delhi government gave an affidavit that they required two more years in order to complete this exercise. So I say this in a spirit not to lay the blame on any party, but to say that a lot of work still needs to be done, and hence this request for an extension, and it's my expectation that this House will pass this bill so that the sword of Damocles, which hangs on the poor people of Delhi and different categories, will no longer, the threat of punitive action will not be there. Why is the problem taking place? Everyone knows, Mr. Deputy Chairman, that the population of Delhi at the time of our independence in 1947 was less than 10 lakhs. After the ravages of the partition and hundreds of thousands of people who came in to Delhi, the population went up, according to the 1951 census, to be something like 15, 16 lakhs. Today, that is the 2016 figures on which we have estimates, the population of Delhi is 186 lakhs. So what is happening is that people, one honorable member mentioned 6 lakhs of people coming into Delhi every year. It may well be more than that. It could be less. There is no system of making a precise calculation of the number of people who are coming in. But what this has resulted in is consequences, and these consequences are unauthorized constructions, jhuggi jhopri colonies, lots of other building activity, which my learned friend, Mr. Sri Vijay Goyal, said that behind the facade of the jhuggi jhopri colony, there are five-story buildings which are being constructed. So this is a fact of life. What we need to do, Mr. Deputy Chairman, sir, is I will take up the offer of all those who said that we should all sit down together and try and work out a system whereby Delhi's slow deterioration into a total slum. Somebody said 70% of Delhi lives there. Once we have the calculations done by this committee, we will get a full idea, and then we will need to start the whole process of rectification. But may I also very briefly refer to some of the other issues which were raised. Reference was made to a blind school. Let me clarify on the record, as I did in the Lok Sabha yesterday. Mr. Deputy Chairman, sir, this is an illegal construction on DDA land. This was not a school for those four blind children, but those who were undertaking this illegal activity used these poor blind children as a ruse, as a front. We offered them alternate placement in another blind school nearby. Notices have been sent to them for the last several months, but some, I would say, irresponsible elements from within our society put these. This was an incident, incidentally, which took place on 15th December. It hit the press only 2 or 3 days ago, deliberately timed for this kind of discussion, I suspect. But we have offered to rehabilitate these children in another school. We have also said that the people who are undertaking this illegal activity on encroached land cannot use the excuse of these four blind students in order to be able to regularize their own illegal activity. A reference was made to a metro inauguration, Mr. Deputy Chairman, sir. Let me clarify for the record that this was an inauguration done in the state of UP. It was an inauguration of the UP part of the metro. And there was the authorities in UP.
That is hardly 10%
of you. No, please. I know you brought the metro. Please. You should now also encourage that the metro thrives and it's not reduced. Now not become like the DTC. Let me explain to you. This inauguration was done in the UP segment of the metro. If you want to encourage another inauguration in Delhi or something, I would request you to use your margin of persuasion with the Honorable Chief Minister of Delhi. Tell him to send the proposals for phase 4 of the metro, which have been pending with him for the last God knows how many years. He should also take other steps to encourage the public transport, because our policy is to move people around, but we are moving cars around. So I am not doing.
That's okay.
So let me come back. Then the issue was raised, Mr. Deputy Chairman, of the Kathputli colony. Let me explain.
Reply in brief.
Very brief. This is an in situ rehabilitation program. I have mentioned to Mr. Raja that all the people who live there will be provided modern, efficient accommodation there itself. The issue is of their temporary location till those flats are built. And this is, in fact, not to be able to do that, we were holding these people to ransom. We were not allowing that project to take off. For 8 years, it has been pending. And I'm very happy to inform this House through you, Mr. Deputy Chairman, that we have now finally succeeded through a court-directed process of being able to proceed with that project, and those who were not covered by the original sanction, etc., we are also trying to find ways with the help of the court to how we can rehabilitate these other people. With these limited comments, Mr. Deputy Chairman, sir, I commend that the bill be.
Okay. No.
Yes, I should add that. We are acting on that. You are absolutely right. In fact, I am separately, you know, there was a reference made to smart and not smart. Let me just say that we are, in fact, allocating a separate piece of land for as a heritage site, where the kind of skills and art forms which were practiced in the Kathputli colony, those very people and artisans will be able to practice it there. So now that we have got the accommodation part sorted out, the second part of a dedicated site for these artisans to practice and the artists to practice, that will be provided for. And I am saying this on the record.
Now, see.
No, honorable, see, what happened, no, no, what argument. Happened and who, what happened and who broke the law, I don't want to get into a discussion.
Honorable
on
Minister,
that.
I have a suggestion for you. Yeah. I, I have a suggestion for you.
Yes, Mr. Dhanasekara.
Sit down. That is, you please take initiative to sort out the friction between the Lieutenant Governor and the Chief Minister.
Yes, I, Mr. Deputy Chairman, sir, I, in four decades, in
initiative. Mr. Deputy Chairman,
sir, in four decades of public life, I face many challenges. I've tried to negotiate with terrorists, etc. This is going to be a difficult one, but I will accept your challenge and I will try and negotiate. I will invite both of them for lunch and something, and I will try and sort this out. As far as Khan Market is concerned, I also want to say that I know a little more about Khan Market than most people. My grandfather was allocated a refugee rehabilitation property there, a flat. So I've seen the kind of encroachments and other issues to which Honorable Naresh Ji mentioned. And I will certainly follow this up. Thank you very much.
And I now recommend that the bill be adopted. National capital. Why we did no. No, please.
Actually, the blind children.
Yeah. In situ rehabilitation means on an as is, where is basis. At the most, they will be, for the time being.
Yeah.
Put it. Madam, this large scale eviction happened only once when civil liberties.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yes.
Mr.
Sit down. Yes. Question is that National Capital Territory of Delhi Laws, Second Amendment, Bill 2017, as passed by Lok Sabha, be taken into consideration. Those in favor, please say aye. Those against, please say no. I think the ayes have it, motion is adopted. We shall now take up clause by clause consideration of the bill. Clause 2 stand part of the bill. There is one amendment, number 1, by Dr. Subbaram Reddy. Are you moving?
Already extension has been given.
Now, order, please, order. Extension you didn't speak, then why do you say?
From 2014 to actually 2017.
Clarification only
2011 to 2014. Two times they have given. So, what I suggest now, instead of 2020, if you make 2022 my suggestion, you will be able to give more time to provide proper planning and regularization of unauthorized colonies and also relocation of rehabilitation of Jukki Jumpuri clusters. Therefore, I am not moving, but I will give you the suggestion.
Yes, thank you. Yeah, not moved. I shall now put clause 2 to vote. Those in favor, please say aye. Those against, please say no. I think the ayes have clause 2 is adopted. Clause 3 stand part of the bill. There is one amendment, number 2 by Subbaram Reddy again. Yes.
Clause 3, sir?
Are you moving?
No. Same thing, actually, I'm not moving. Same thing.
Yeah. He's not moving. You may consider it. That's all. He has not moved it. I shall now put clause 3 to vote. Those in favor, please say aye. Those against, please say no. I think the ayes have clause 3 is adopted. Clause 4 stands part of the bill. There is one amendment again by Dr. Subbaram Reddy.
Sir, here I would like
he is the only one who is
I would like to suggest
moving amendment. Look
the
at
extension up to 31st December 2022, you suggested so that you will have the more time for adequate for town planning.
Yeah.
I am not moving.
Not moving, yes. Actually, very generous. You are not moving. Very kind. Yeah. Okay, motion not moved. I shall now put clause 4 to vote. Those in favor, please say aye. Those against, please say no. I think the ayes have clause 4 is adopted. Clause 5 stands part of the bill. There are two amendments, numbers 4 and 5 by Dr. T. Subbaram Reddy.
Two amendments also, same thing I am telling. As I said above already, relocation, rehabilitation of Jukki villages and from the existing clusters is a long process, therefore requires detailed planning. The extension 2022, think of it.
Not moved.
Not moved. And other one also, same thing, I'm not moving.
Okay, not moving. I shall now put clause 5 to vote. Those in favor, please say aye. Those against, please say no. I think the ayes have clause 5 is adopted. Clause 6 stands part of the bill. Those in favor, please say aye. Those against, please say no. I think the ayes have clause 6 is adopted. Clause 1, the enacting formula and the title stand part of the bill. Those in favor, please say aye. Those against, please say no. I think the ayes have clause 1. The enacting formula and title are adopted. Now, Sir Hardeep Singh Puri to move that the bill be passed. Yes, motion moved that the bill be passed. Question is that the bill be passed. Those in favor, please say aye. Those against, please say no. I think the ayes have bill is passed.